All praises. Today's topic, can you put up the thumbnail so we know what we're talking about today? So I know what I'm talking about. We're talking about Japan and Bible prophecy. Japan and Bible prophecy. Yeah, shout out to the brothers or sister that made the thumbnail. I'm not sure who made it, but I do like that one right there. We're going to open up with some little bit of history, as I often do. And some of the history you know about, because you've sat in some of the classes, and some of them you may not know about. Who's reading for me today?
Officer Yakub Bishop.
Okay. Officer Yakub, all right. Isaac, he's...
Yeah, he's good. Hey, we count on you, bro.
Yes, sir, D.
No pressure.
All right. Officer Yakub, let's read this first book right here. Hey, at sundown, can I get some hot ginger tea at sundown, please? For my, I'm jacked up. Go ahead.
The Critical Review, or Annals of Literature, by a Society of Gentlemen.
All right, when was this book written? We went over this last week. Who knows the year? I'm not good in Roman numerals.
1883.
Is that the year? Oh, well, anyway, let's go into the book. somebody Google that. All right, read that. The highlight area.
Pope Nicholas V is that famous bull. In that famous bull by which he granted the unknown world to the Portuguese and Spaniards.
So the Portuguese and the Spaniards. Remember those two. Portuguese and the Spaniards, Scott.
Expressly permitted and ordered the Christians to reduce all infidels into slavery.
So infidel means unbelievers. If you did not believe in white supremacy Christianity, you were made a slave. Go ahead.
An order zealously executed by both these nations.
Now, I'm glad it said Christians, because when you speak to apologetics, whatever the hell they call themselves, they're quick to say that was only the Catholics. It was not the Protestants. But the Protestants, when they protested and separated from the Catholic Church, they did not undo slavery. In fact, they further enforced it. So always remember that. Go back to the book. It is warm in here. Go down. Raise it up. Raise it up. Right there.
Professor Springle divides the history of the Negro trade carried on by Christians into two principal periods. The first from 1443 to 1645, and the second from 1645 to the present time.
So the present times was 1830.
The first period.
That was a year. Something like that. It's 1830 something. Got it.
The first period is the time of its increase, during which not only its founders, the Portuguese, but the English, the Dutch, and the French dealt in Negro slaves.
Now, I want y'all to notice. So it said the founders, the Portuguese, English, Dutch, and the French, good, dealt what?
Dealt in Negro slaves.
Uh-huh.
Though chiefly for the use of consumption of the Spaniards and the sugar and tobacco plantations in the Brazils. During the latter period, these four nations were obliged to share that trade with the Swedes.
Go ahead. Next page. Next page.
With the Swedes, the Danes, the Brandenburgers, the North Americans, and since 1778, with the Spaniards.
Now, what I want y'all to notice is that Japan is not mentioned. Go down. Japan is not mentioned. Go ahead.
The discovery of the Gold Coast served, indeed, yet more to enlarge the sphere of the navigation of the Portuguese than their slave trade. But it forced them also to extend themselves on the coast and to settle colonies in Congo, Angola, and other places, which they had till then neglected. King John II in 1492 expelled all the Jews to the island of St. Thomas.
So King John II expelled all the Jews to the island of St. Thomas, which is on the coast of Africa. Go ahead.
which had been
Now, the first reading, you would think those Jews is white folks. But as we read on, it's going to tell you it's not. Go ahead.
Which had been discovered in 1471 and to other Portuguese settlements on the continent of Africa. And from there, banished... And from these banished Jews, the Black Portuguese, as they are called, and the Jews of Luango...
Luango's in Africa.
...who are despised, even by the very Negroes, are descended.
So the Jews were called the Black Portuguese. Those were all black people that was expelled to the coast of Africa. Okay, everybody see that? All right. Give me the highlighted next section.
These Negroes were purchased in Guinea, Congo, and Manicongo, and the colonists had plantations furnished with from 150 to 3,000 Negro slaves. In the beginning of the 16th century, the Spaniards and Portuguese began to transport Negroes for similar labors to the West Indies and Brazils, by which the Negro trade was rapidly increased.
Now, let's go to the next book. Read that.
The Southern Literary Messenger, devoted to every department of literature and the fine arts.
What year was this published?
1860.
Let's go inside the book.
We are told that the Negro was a stranger in Egypt, an alien in a foreign land, and that in the ancient world, the alien was uniformly regarded as an enemy. And was most commonly reduced to slavery, and that the relations in which he appears on the monuments of the Nile resulted from his position as an alien.
So they're letting you know that the Negroes in Egypt were Israelites. That's what that's saying. Next page. Zoom in at the bottom.
In respect to the monumental period, the proofs are all strong in the same direction. When the Negro races first made their appearance on the monuments of Egypt, it is in the relations of slavery.
Sometimes
indeed of capacity, but more commonly of
captivity.
Sometimes indeed of captivity, but more commonly of established slavery. This, until we came down to our own times, was therefore the universal status. Slaves. Then.
When. Caris.
Come on, y'all, blow it back up. Slaves, then when Carousel and Luxor were built, slaves in Europe, Asia, Africa, and America, slaves in Thebes.
Now, it mentions Asia there, but it's not being specific because Asia's huge. Go ahead.
Slaves in Europe, Asia, Africa, and America, slaves in Thebes and Memphis, at Babylon and Nineveh, at Rome and Athens.
So these places are where the Israelites were all made slaves at. Go ahead.
At Carthage and Constantinople, at Havana, and Richmond, slaves at all times and in all places under all forms of government.
Raise it up. Go to the right.
Under every modification of society, under every considerable combination of circumstances. Conceivable combination of circumstances. Slavery seems to have been emphatically the history of this race.
So it's saying that the Negro has always been in slavery. So when you read, hold that, give me that one in Jeremiah 2. How about is Israel a slave, that one?
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 2 and verse 14. Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave?
Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Go ahead.
Why is he spoiled?
Every time you read the Bible, our people are in captivity over and over and over. Give me the next book, please. Next book.
Who's Who in Philadelphia?
Raise it up. By Charles Fred White. This was published, I want to say 1912. Give me the inside the book. Watch this. Zoom in. The Negro.
The Negro learns from history that Hannibal, the world's greatest general and one of the greatest statesmen, was of Ethiopian blood.
He was black, but we found out he was an Israelite. Jump down to the next highlighted section.
That King Solomon, the wise man of our Bible, proudly acknowledged that he was black.
So Solomon admitted he was black, right?
That the Jews were mixed with African breed and much of the beauty of their religion.
Right, because remember, some of our mothers were Canaanites. You had Jacob married Leah and Rachel. No. Yeah. And then there were four concubines. Put it back on the screen. They don't need to see me. Put it back on the screen. Next section.
That Jesus Christ himself was as much a Negro as some of the race you persecute.
Y'all see that right there? So they said, can I get it? Do y'all do bombs here?
Boom.
Boom.
Come on, IT.
What is this? New York? What the hell is this?
Officer Zamar, come on.
Wow. Wow. Give me the next page. Just kill the spirit. Give me the next page. I'm going back. Go ahead.
All Japanese cultures, religion, education, the Shendayai language, etc., are distinctly Mongolian. Jimmu Tenno brought Negroes with the sun and fire worship from Mesopotamia and through Manchuria.
Now, what I want y'all to see that part right there. Now, this is the first time we're getting into the Japanese now. All Japanese cultures, religion, what did it say? No, I'm looking over here, but I ain't got it. Oh, I want that name there. Jimmu Tenno brought Negroes with the sun and fire worship from Mesopotamia, which is Babylon. So there was a Japanese guy named Jimmu Tenno, okay, that brought people, Israelites, over to Japan during the time of Nebuchadnezzar. Raise it up. Read the next section.
To be a good samurai, fighting servant, one must have half black blood in one's veins.
Wait, read it again. Read it again.
To be a good samurai, fighting servant, one must have half black blood in one's veins.
Do y'all see that? Can I get a bomb on that? Do these guys know something that I don't know?
Get it together, Samar.
I guess he already knew this information already. He already knew it. That's why he's out teaching. You see all his videos. He already knew it.
You're late. I'm late.
Sorry, Zamar. We know. Bam. You're already there. Go ahead, read down.
Said the old proverb, in those days, they were not ashamed to acknowledge their black descent, but were proud of it.
That's right. So, there was a Netflix film called Yasuke. If we can put it on the screen, I don't think we'll get a flag for it because it is a trailer. So put that on the screen. Let's just take a look at it to show you that the black samurai Yasuke.
These items come from far and wide. You will be the only man on this side of the world to claim such treasures.
You dare speak to me? You will pay for your insolence.
Mate, what honor is there in striking down a child?
Stop. Pause it. I want y'all to see how the black guy, Yasuke, Yasuke means the black one. That's what it means. You see how he's dressed? These are the Portuguese. He came with the Portuguese. I'm going to get into that in a minute. Play on.
To speak?
Lord Nobunaga awards those who have proven themselves.
Because the Portuguese went to Japan.
And what do they call you? The samurai that was once a servant.
Yasuke.
You have my respect.
Yasuke He's not one of us. Our people will not accept him.
I will soon represent the people, and I will usher them into a new world.
The Dark Army approaches.
Look at you, Yaskir. The only one who didn't betray me.
All that is left for me is an honorable death. This is my final command of you, my friend.
All right, stop it right there. Thank you. That's all I wanted out of that.